On the afternoon of September 10th, 2023, at 3:13 p.m. local time, a body of lava burst through the caldera floor of Kilauea, starting a new eruption. This eruption followed a signal of magma rising to the surface, which was observed only 41 minutes earlier. The first vent to erupt initially created a lava fountain which was 46 meters or 151 feet in height. A second vent erupted 40 seconds later, followed by a third 60 seconds later, and a fourth an additional 60 seconds later. Within 15 minutes of the eruption's onset, 9 vents were simultaneously erupting along a 4,100-foot-long fissure which trended towards the east. Thankfully, no one is in immediate danger due to this eruption, as it is completely confined within Kilauea's 2018 caldera, and there are currently no indications that lava will propagate into either of Kilauea's two rift zones, so this eruption will likely remain completely confined to the 2018 caldera. Luckily, if all of these 9 currently erupting vents remain active, they will allow for the best possible view of a Kilauea summit eruption in more than a decade. As, while the closest you could view an active vent was from 4,100 feet away during the last few eruptions, today you can get within 1,400 feet of an erupting vent. Although there could be variable closures due to the eruption, the National Park Service recommended 3 viewing sites which I have placed blue stars at. As long as this site does not close, I recommend the specific viewing site which is furthest south of the 3. This is because for the first time since a section of Kilauea's caldera collapsed and widened in 2018, lava has erupted outside of the lowermost of the down-dropped block. In contrast, all 5 eruptions that Kilauea produced since the end of 2018 have occurred within the deepest part of the caldera. As for the eruption which just occurred, it began at these points. Lava from these vents can be seen flowing towards the west, and as of 12 hours after the eruption's onset, at least a square kilometer has been coated in a glowing orange layer of lava, adding an average of 2 feet thick of lava to the Halemaumau crater. You might have noticed a strong white plume of volcanic gases rising from the eruption site, which had greatly reduced the visibility in the region. This plume can be a potential health hazard, so you need to stay upwind of it, as it contains fairly abundant sulfur dioxide. On day 1 of Kilauea's new eruption, 100,000 metric tons of sulfur dioxide were estimated to have been released, leading to a volcanic fog known as Vog. This fog will probably dissipate over time, as the highest gas emissions and strongest lava output generally occur during day 1 of Kilauea's eruptions. Lava output will progressively decrease over time along with resulting sulfur dioxide emissions until its eruption finally ends. Although about half of Kilauea's eruptions since 1900 have lasted a week or less, some eruptions have lasted as long as 33 years in length. We do not know how long Kilauea's current eruption will last for, but I will speculate the following. The current eruption appears to have had a lower initial eruptive volume than the 12-day long eruption which began on June 7, 2023. Thus, the current eruption may very well only last for less than a 12-day long duration, but we do not know, it could last significantly longer. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.